is defined as x cube when x square is less than 1 and x when x square is greater than or equal to 1. Okay? Then, which of the following option is correct? Then f of x is option number A. Continuous as well as differentiable at x equal to 1. Continuous and differentiable at x equal to 1. Differentiable but not continuous at x equal to 1. This is absurd option. Continuous but not differentiable at x equal to 1. And option D, none of the above. So first is continuous and differentiable at 1. Differentiable but not continuous at x equal to 1. That's not possible. And continuous but not differentiable at x equal to 1. And none of the above. It's continuous but not differentiable.
At x equal to 1.
Okay. What is the meaning of this? This is another way of expressing that your x is lying between
minus 1.
Because the moment you do x square minus 1 less than 0, we actually think of the wavy curve. Correct? And if you draw a wavy curve, you'll have a minus 1, 1. This will be positive, negative, positive. So it will be negative in this interval. So this is as good as saying that your x is between minus 1 and 1. This is as good as saying your x is greater than 1 or your x is less than minus 1. So if you go by the graphical approach of solving this, you have to follow the x cube graph in this interval. So basically from minus 1 to 1, I'll stop like this, correct? This is 1, this is minus 1. I will not draw the x cube graph completely. I will only stop between minus 1 to 1. Now, when x is greater than 1, it is going to follow a straight line like this. Right? When x is less than minus 1, it is again going to follow a straight line like this. Clearly suggesting that there is a kink getting formed over here because of the abrupt change in the direction. But guys, never completely trust graphs. Never completely trust graphs. Why I'm saying that is because there are certain occasions where even though a curve has translated to a line, there is a smoothness over there. Correct? If I talk about such a scenario where you had a parabola and all of a sudden it has become a line like this.
It need not be a...
You know, here it is differentiable actually.
Yeah, actually, it's not a
thing. Correct? That's what. Many people think, oh, from curve it became a line, so there has to be a kink cutting form, hence non-differentiable. No. You have to go at a micro level. Exactly. If you see here the left hand derivative, this function is, let's say, x square function, and this is, let's say, y equal to 0 function. Y equal to 0 function. This is y equal to x square function. The left hand derivative will be what? What is the left hand derivative for this function at 0? Differentiate to x, put 0, what do you get? 0. What is the derivative of 0 itself? 0. So it has to be differentiable at 0. Of course, continuity is there. So in this case, it is differentiable. So my point here was, okay, in this case it was very obvious, but do not over rely on graph. Do not over rely on the fact that, oh, there is a change on the curve from a curve to a line. So there has to be a kink there. Correct? So in this case, we need to always check. Let's say I want to check mathematically whether there is a king there or not. What will I do? Slightly left to 1, differentiate the function, put 1. Slightly right to 1, differentiate the function, put 1. So slightly left to 1, which function are you following?
X cube.
X cube. What's the derivative of x cube at 1?
3.
3x square. Put 1. 3t. So the slope of this tangent here will be 3. So that means if you draw a tangent like this, this tangent will have a slope of 3. What is the slope of this?
1.
Are these two slopes equal? Hence, there is a king getting formed. Is that fine? In the same way here also, left to minus 1, the slope is 1.
Minus 3.
Right to minus 1, the slope is negative 3. They are not equal, hence not differentiable. Is that fine? Next question. So option number C is correct. There is a function defined like this. X times e to the power 1 by x minus e to the power negative 1 by x divided by e to the power 1 by x plus e to the power negative 1 by x. This is when x is not 0. And it is 0 when x is 0. Okay? This is how a function is defined. Now, question is, the function f of x is option A, continuous everywhere. Continuous everywhere, but not differentiable at x equal to 0. But not differentiable at x equal to 0. Option B, continuous and differentiable everywhere, option C, not continuous at 0, option D, none of the above. So here the point of contention is 0 point, correct? So first check its continuity at 0, then we'll check its differentiability if required. It's not continuous. Left hand limit at 0, let's find it out. Zero minus.
So, what happens when the aspirant going negative? It's not continuous.
Okay, let's check. Let's do one thing. Let's take 1 by x as negative y. Okay? Let's take 1 by x as negative y. Now, would you all agree with me when I say when x tends to 0 minus, y would tend to? Y would tend to?
Minus
infinity or plus infinity?
Plus infinity.
Because I have already taken 1 by x as negative y. Correct. And 0 left is also negative. So this will be a huge negative number with huge magnitude negative number. And if you have equated it to minus y, then y has to be a very huge positive number. The benefit of doing this is we can convert this to limit y tending to infinity. This will become negative 1 by y, e to the power 1 by x will be negative y, e to the power y, by e to the power y plus e to the power, correct? Yes? Limit x to the power n n tending to infinity, when mod x is less than 1, it will become 0. This one you are asking? Limit x tending to x to the power n tending to infinity, if mod of x is less than 1, then this will become 0. Yes, now tell me the answer for this.
Well, it is showing you to be...
It is 0.
Yeah, the limit doesn't exist.
It's an indeterminate form.
Will it be 0? If you take an e to the power y common, what happens to this term? It will become 1, 1 each. Correct? This will become an e to the power y will get cancelled. Correct? Okay. Now this term would be 0 by the very base, this definition itself. So your x is like 1 by e now. Correct? X is 1 by e and your n is like 2y. Why does it become 0? 1 by e to the power of a very large number. 1 by e is approximately 0.3 something, 39 something, right? If you raise it to a very high power, it will become 0. What will happen to this number also? 0. Okay? So can I say it will be just boiled down to minus 1 by y plus? And when x y tends to infinity, this will actually become 0. Now what about the right hand limit as x tends to 0?
It's going to be minus.
Okay. Now when x tends to plus 0, okay, again can I do one thing? Let y be 1 by x. So y will now tend to infinity. Okay. So I can write the same thing as, let me correct it over here itself. Limit y tending to infinity. This will become 1 by y, e to the power y minus e to the power minus y, by again e to the power y plus e to the power minus y. Guys, again if you take e to the power y common out, what will happen? 1 by y, 1 minus e to the power minus 2y, by 1 plus e to the power minus 2y, that becomes again 1 by y, because this term will go to 0, this term will go to 0, and this will, since y is infinity, this will again give you 0. And does it match with the value of the function at 0? Yes. So those who said it is discontinuous at 0, the answer is no. It is continuous at x equal to 0. But is it differentiable at x equal to 0? Let's check that. And after that, I would also like you to plot this on your desktop and check. Was it actually continuous at 0 and differentiable?
Differentiability, can we differentiate the function?
Of course you can. Left hand derivative, right hand derivative, you can find out separately. But you know, the best way is use first principles here. You would be surprised, but that would be faster. Right? Should I show you the first principles?
Yeah.
Okay. Somebody please note this function down because I am changing the page. Should I compress it? Become very, very small. Yeah. Now, what will be the left hand derivative at 0? The basic definition of left hand derivative is what? F of x minus h minus of f of x by h. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to replace x with minus h. Isn't it? And this is the definition, huh? Yeah. H tending to 0 plus f of 0 minus h minus f of 0 by h, correct? So f of 0 minus h means what? F of minus h. So here I will put x as minus h, so it will become minus h e to the power of minus 1 by h minus e to the power of plus 1 by h whole divided by e to the power of minus 1 by h plus e to the power of 1 by h, correct? F of 0 is what?
0.
0. And if I divide by h, in fact minus h, I would say, it will be this. Yes or no? Minus h goes. Now again the same story, I don't want to repeat. E to the power 1 by h tending to 0 plus, what will happen to that? Think carefully and then answer. E to the power minus 1 by h, as h tends to 0 will be what?
Zero.
It will become e to the power minus infinity, which is 1 by e to the power infinity.
Zero.
So if I take e to the power 1 by h common out, from both the numerator and denominator, let me make the change here. This will become a 1. This will become minus 2. Correct? So can I say this will be 0, this will be 0, this will get cancelled with each other, leaving you the answer as a negative 1. Now in the same logic, I want you all to tell me what's the right hand derivative at 0. Be careful while doing that. This is a potential question in your school exam and also mark it with a star. It's
1.
Absolutely. So limit h tending to 0 plus f of 0 plus h minus f of 0 by h. F of 0 plus h means replace x with h everywhere. Is it fine? This is what you must all be getting?
Yes.
Now take e to the power 1 by h common out. If you do that, you get h 1 minus e to the power minus 2h. H 1 minus 1 plus e to the power minus 2 by h. What will happen to these terms? 0, 0, h, h gone. Answer is 1. So is the left hand derivative, right hand derivative at 0 same?
No.
So it is not differentiable at 1. That means option number A is correct. It's continuous everywhere, but not differentiable at x equal to 0. Somebody please plot it on the graph and check. Quick. Awesome. Not differentiable.
Yes.
Is it sharp?
Yes.
Fine. This is what she is getting. Fine? Yes.
Not differentiable.
Not differentiable at all. Okay. Are you not confident about this topic? Or one more problem should I take up?
Yeah.
One more. While evaluating limits, please be extra cautious. These things are something where you will be tested upon. So that property which I wrote there, limit x tending x to the power n tending to infinity and where mod x is less than 1, the answer is always 0. That's helpful in many cases. Let's take another one.